mission, I want to assure you that you really mean something. And I want to thank the leader of that choir group. Our mama did a very wonderful job. So I want us all to give her a very... set a pace for us as men to follow. So and I hope that by the time we end this event today, we'll also gather next week and everyone will put their hands together for us. So there's been some very wonderful men who have been doing some tireless work behind the scene to make sure that what we're going to see today is possible. And you know, this we cannot do without the presence of God. So I'll be very disappointed in myself if I don't say we should also clap for Jesus. You know, sometimes there are men and there are boys. And there are men and there are also women. In Nigeria, Ikeledi Ishuku, Isuchuku, Yom Shadro, and the rest. So one of them was running from Lagos to the east, Onitsha. So they met armed robbers along the way. So the armed robbers came, you know, at one point and started shooting into the air and asked everybody to come down. So everybody came down. And then they said the men should be on this side. And then the women should be on this side. So they all took their position. The men were on this side and the women were on this side. But the armed robbers was about to start taking everything that they had. So when the armed robbers were surprised that one of the men actually queued up on the side of the women. And then the armed robber went to him and said, "Abuga, which one are you, not the man?" And then the man said, "Well, you think those people are men? If they were men, why would they respect you? You are the people that are men, we are all women. So they should join here and stay on the side of the women. Praise the Lord." No. Praise the Lord. You know the Bible says, "Rejoice ye that is in you, and ye that is in the world." I always tell people that you are what you speak about yourself. You're living today as a result of what you declared about yourself yesterday. And how you're going to live tomorrow will be as a result of what you declared about yourself today. So if you're spending your time lamenting and looking at every reason why you have not been able to make it, be very sure that you are already sowing a seed of negativity for your future. The Bible said, "Cast your burden unto me." You know, for you to get to the next level in life, there has to be a storm. And that's why God said, "I will give you double for your trouble." So for you to get God's double, you need to have a trouble. I stand here as a living testimony of how you can go through storm and overcome your storm and begin to declare wonderful testimonies that your enemies will not be able to comprehend. Those who may call you names today, I want you to join me in praying for them that they should live long, so that when your time of testimony comes, they will come and eat your jollof rice and your pounded yam and your pepper soup with you. Because God has called you for a purpose. And he who has called you is greater than those who are calling you names. Can you put a round of applause for yourself as we move on? I would have sat for my wife too, but I don't wish I would have allowed us all. You know, it's a popular parable in Nigeria that live with employed seeing how we live our lives. We're Christians and we should not be fooled by those economists who are human beings like you, forecasting and putting some tightening economic policies that are now making us feel that our God no longer exists. Our God who exists. Praise the Lord. Our God who exists. And if we continue to carry that confidence and that faith that the Bible has taught us to carry, we are able to overcome. And that's why the Bible describes us as overcomers. You know? Let me tell you something before I proceed to the next one. You know, I came into this country in the thick of the winter. And I remember when I was being transported from Schiphol Airport to where they took us to, I saw trees that did not have leaves. And they were dead and standing. And so I was asking myself, these trees are this abroad, they respect even people and animals and even plants. And these trees were actually in my country who would not cut them to firewood. So I wonder why they still keep them. You know? But unknowing to me, the tree had mouths to talk to me. And this is what the tree would have told me. I know these are my difficult moments, Brother Sonny. I know this snow have killed me. I am now naked. I don't have anything to be proud of anymore. But I just pray that this your trip that brought you here can keep you until summer, when my green leaves will grow again, when I will become shelter to people like you who want to take shade under my tree. That's how our life is. There is a moment of winter.
Amen.
There is a moment of summer. And that's why God made the world in season. If it rains continuously, it will be flooded. And there's also the time that it will rain, and there is time that the sun will come. And if you continue to sun, there will be drought. So while it is raining in some parts, and that is becoming a blessing to some people in some part of the world, it is a cost to some people at a time. And when the time of sun comes, while the sun is scorched, to some people in my country, Nigeria, it becomes too hot. While in some areas, they want to go crazy and go naked. That is how our life is. So there is no moment in your life that is permanent. Everything has a time. And that even in prosperity, there is a limit to when you begin to see the flow of prosperity. Even in cash. And that's why the people in the world say no condition is permanent. You know that. You know, we all came to this world destined. Just like the Bible said about Jeremiah, it said, before your mother conceived thee, the womb I knew thee. Before you were even born, I had set thee apart as a prophet unto the nation.
Amen.
So we all have a purpose while we are here. And some of us will not achieve that purpose. I'm sorry to say. Because you are looking for the easiest way. You know, some of our brothers and sisters, even in the church, wait until a brother has dared to take that step before they want to follow. That is why when money comes, they still want to open an African shop. When money comes again, they want to open a barber shop, because they start to lose their barber shop and they've seen like 10, 20 people barbering at any one day. So I'm challenging you to take a step into the area that has not been discovered yet. I love this country. There's still so much potential to be tapped in this country. But unfortunately, we are all saturating the area that is already saturated. So the blessings have been splitted among too many people that it's too small what you're chasing. When I started the United States, the struggle people thought I was joking. I started here. I remember when we wrote pen, me and my wife held the pen, so I remember it was Bishop who prayed for us. But today, I know where the Lord has taken it. A friend of mine who came from Italy, I didn't even know that the woman that I met somewhere last year in Rome at a conference is now the current Minister of Foreign Affairs in Italy. So, and today, if you're asking anything about the Niger Delta, go to anywhere
right.